Good morning. My name is Zsuzsanna McMahan, and I'm going to provide you with a brief overview of our poster entitled Anti-Vinculin Antibodies and Systemic Sclerosis, Associations with Gastric Transit and Extraintestinal Clinical Phenotype. One of the most common affected organ systems in systemic sclerosis is the gastrointestinal tract. While up to 90% of patients are affected, the presentation of gastrointestinal manifestations in systemic sclerosis is highly variable, as any segment of the gut may be involved, and the timing of symptom onset is often unpredictable. The lack of biomarkers can also lead to significant clinical challenges when trying to predict patients who are at high risk for rapid progression of gastrointestinal dysfunction and poor outcomes. Vinculin is a cytoskeletal protein that binds to actin and promotes cell adhesion and gut motility. A recent study demonstrated a positive association between anti-vinculin antibody levels and gastrointestinal symptom severity measured through a self-reported symptom survey. The aim of our study was to use more objective measures of gastrointestinal dysfunction, such as the whole gut transit study, to determine whether anti-vinculin antibodies associate with specific types of gastrointestinal dysmotility and to define the clinical phenotype of this group of patients. We used sera from 88 well-characterized patients with systemic sclerosis and screened the sera for anti-vinculin antibodies by ELISA. We then compared whole gut scintigraphy, gastrointestinal symptom scores, and clinical features between patients with and without these antibodies. As you can see in our results in our poster, 25% of our cohort had anti-vinculin antibodies. Patients with anti-vinculin antibodies were more likely to have limited scleroderma, thyroid disease, and a higher or better DLCO on pulmonary function testing. Importantly, higher levels of anti-vinculin antibodies were also associated with delayed gastric emptying on the whole gut transit study in the univariate analysis. And this association importantly remained significant even after adjusting for age and sex. We conclude that our patients with anti-vinculin antibodies have a distinct clinical phenotype. Longitudinal studies, however, are needed to determine the ability of these antibodies to predict the risk of slow gastric transit in our patients.